start was excellent. So let's invite Vinod Aggarwal, the CEO of the commercial vehicle segment at Eicher Motors. Mr. Aggarwal, good morning and thank you very much for joining us. That's quite a jump you saw in December, 5,068 vehicles compared to November's 3,639. Is this seasonal at all? We are normally told that things are bad in December, but you've done excellently well. Is this a trend that we can continue in the first quarter of calendar 2016?
No, December month, it's as per our plan. Basically, we had planned this growth and we had anticipated very well that the industry is going to grow. And in line with our expectation, the industry has ended very well in 2015. And overall industry, 5-ton and above, has grown by 25%. Now the industry is at 387,000 5-ton and above, as against 447,000. That was the earlier peak in 2011. So, and the industry growth is in line with our expectation, and in anticipation of this growth, we had planned these numbers and we have met our plans.
So, what is the expectation for 2016, Mr. Aggarwal? What kind of industry growth are you expecting?
2016, basically the growth will be led by the infrastructure investments. So, I would say that construction boom, if the road construction sector especially, if that takes off, we will see much more growth in the CV industry, because we shouldn't forget that we are still less than our earlier peak of 2011. But within the CV industry, the heavy duty trucks, they are growing very well, and last year they have grown, 2015, they have grown by 36% overall, and they are at almost at now 90% of the earlier peak. But within heavy duty trucks, the construction trucks are still growing by only around 5% for the full year. So overall 36% growth, and construction trucks only 5%. So next year I would say that if the construction sector takes off, we will see more growth in the truck industry.
Okay. Mr. Aggarwal, can you size up for us the impact of the Chennai floods? Does it open up opportunities for you because others are weakened, or does it also weaken you because suppliers could be badly hit?
No, I think the situation is back to normal as far as the supply of components are concerned, because we are largely dependent on Chennai for supply of parts and components, and for us it has not impacted much, because we had the adequate inventory 5 to 7 days or 10 days for some parts, and within that period we were able to get back to normal. We are not impacted by the Chennai floods in the trucks.
Okay, all the vendors are also back to normal. They are not facing labor shortages or anything like that?
No.
Okay. Mr. Aggarwal, because of the ban on older commercial vehicles that we saw in Delhi recently, what would the incremental demand be in the replacement segment? How much do you think it could go up by?
No, that's a basically larger issue, because the industry had been talking of that the more than 15 years old vehicles, they need to be replaced through some good schemes, incentive schemes. And then this banning of more than 10-year old vehicles in Delhi, I think this has led to some increase in demand. Some people started buying new trucks because they were to do business in Delhi. So this has led to some demand, but to quantify that how much it is, it's very difficult. But overall, I think this is the right move, that we have to phase out the older vehicles which are not emission friendly.
Will you be raising capacity anytime soon, Mr. Aggarwal? Because you do have a manufacturing facility at Jaipur which has a capacity of 60,000 units per annum. At what point would you like to scale that up?
No, we have a capacity in Pithampur, not in Jaipur. Our capacity currently is 5,500 trucks per month, which is 66,000.
Okay.
And this year we have sold, last year 2015, we have sold 47,500. So we are still less than our total capacity. However, to increase the capacity from 5,500 per month to 7,500 per month is not a big issue. So we can increase that very easily.
Yeah, but then you're almost operating
100,000 per annum.
Yeah, exactly. You're already operating at probably 80%. So will you do that expansion in 2016?
No, that expansion will not mean any major investments, because we are already ready in our machine shop, in our engine capacity, in our paint shop. The only capacity that we have to increase largely is the assembly lines. And assembly lines capacity can be increased by adding more manpower or by adding the shift. Okay. So that's not a big issue for us.
What okay. is your sense that in 2016 you will be crossing 5,500?
Let's hope. I can't give the number, but we are very optimistic. 2016 will be better for CV industry. Definitely it will be better than the 2015.
Okay.
That's what our call is. Because if you look at the CV industry, the light and medium duty trucks, they are still at around 70% of the earlier peak. They are still at 68,000 units per annum, 5 to 15 ton, whereas earlier peak was 100,000. So we are expecting more growth to come from 5 to 15 ton segment. And similarly, in the buses also, the bigger buses, they are still down. The 15-ton buses, which are largely used by the state transport undertakings. So we are expecting more buying programs from the state transport undertakings. So we will see good growth coming from buses. We will see good growth coming from the light and medium-duty trucks. And we will see good growth coming from heavy-duty trucks based on the construction boom.
So
road sector construction.
So can you give us just a two-part question? One on buses, your market share has actually gone up to 15 and almost 15.5%. Where do you think it can go to by the end of next year? And second, can you give us any indication of what the industry growth could be in 2016? Will it be 20%, 25%?
No, I can tell you segment by segment. For example, in the heavy-duty trucks, the earlier peak was 240,000 and last year is 210,000. So we are expecting that 2016, the heavy-duty trucks should touch the new peak in 2016 based on the demand coming from the infrastructure-led investments. And then as far as the light and medium-duty trucks are concerned, the growth always lags the growth from the growth in the heavy-duty trucks. And there also we are expecting more growth to come in because only in the second half of 2015 we have seen the growth in the light and medium duty trucks. So okay. as we go more and more into 2016, we will see more recovery coming in the light and medium duty trucks. And okay. buses, of course, it will continue to grow based on more buying programs from the state transport undertakings, plus the growth in the schools led demand, that will continue. So we are expecting good growth in all the segments.
All right. Mr. Aggarwal, we'll leave it at that. On that positive note, expecting good growth in several segments, hopefully from the infrastructure space as well. That's the word coming in from Eicher Motors commercial segment, commercial vehicle segment, which of course has been actually doing very well.